A. Baldric, also Baldric, Baudric, Baldric as well as other rare or obsolete variations, is a belt worn over one shoulder that is typically used to carry a weapon, usually a sword, or other implements such as a bugle or drum. The word may also refer to any belt in general, but this usage is poetic or archaic. History. Baldrics have been used since ancient times, usually as part of military dress. The early Islamic Arabs wore baldrics with their armor. The design offers more support for weight than a standard waist belt, without restricting movement of the arms, and while allowing easy access to the object carried. For example, the late 18th century British Army's distinctive red coat uniform pattern featured a pair of white baldrics crossed at the chest, with the soldier's bayonet sheath suspended from one and his canteen suspended from the other. Alternatively, and especially in modern times, the baldric may fill a ceremonial role rather than a practical one. Roman baltus. During ancient Roman times, the baltus, plural baltae, was a type of baldric commonly used to suspend a sword. It was a belt generally worn over the shoulder, passing obliquely down to the side, typically made of leather, often ornamented with precious stones, metals, or both. There was also a similar belt worn by the Romans, particularly by soldiers, called a cintus, pl cinti, that fastened around the waist. The word accintus, meaning a soldier, literally, girt as for battle, attests to this differing usage. Today, many non-military or paramilitary organizations include baldrics as part of ceremonial dress. The Knights of Columbus 4th Degree Color Corps uses a baldric as part of their uniform, it supports a ceremonial sword. The University of Illinois Marching Illini wore two baldrics as a part of their uniform until 2009, with one over each shoulder. They crossed in the front and back and were buttoned onto the jacket beneath a cape and epaulettes. Today, the current Marching Illini wears one baldric with two sides. Illini is on one side and the traditional orange and white baldric from the previous uniform. A crossed pair of baldrics is often worn as part of uniform of Morris dance sides. Different colors of baldric help to distinguish different sides. In literature and culture, the baldric appears in the literary canon. Britta Mart, in Edmund Spenser's Fairy Queen, clothes herself in a borrowed armor with brave baldric garnished before embarking on her quest, Book 3. Canto 3. Benedick, from William Shakespeare's Much Ado About Nothing, says but that I will have a recheat winded in my forehead or hang my bugle in an invisible baldric all women shall pardon me. A baldric features prominently in Chapter 4 of Alexander Dumas's The Three Musketeers. The yeoman in Chaucer's Canterbury Tales is described as wearing a baldric of bright green. The baldric of Pallas plays a key part in the Aeneid, leading Aeneas to kill Turnus. In The Fellowship of the Ring, Boromir is described, on a baldric he wore a great horn tipped with silver that now was laid upon his knees. In Sir Gawain and the Green Knight, Gawain returns from his battle with the Green Knight wearing the green girdle obliquely, like a baldric, bound at his side slash below his left shoulder, laced in a knot, in betokening the blame he had borne for his fault. Some Klingons wear baldrics in Star Trek, such as Kor, Koloth, Kong, or Worf, although sometimes they are referred to as a sash. The character Worf does so in almost every one of his appearances through two series and four films. In the Next Generation episode Conundrum, Worf, due to amnesia, mistakenly believes that the baldric indicates his rank or authority, so he briefly assumes command of the Enterprise. Baldric is a character in the BBC comedy series Blackadder, played by Tony Robinson. A baldric is also mentioned in the epic poem by Alfred, Lord Tennyson, The Lady of Shalott, in the 10th stanza, and from his blazon D baldric slung, a mighty silver bugle hung.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.